Hey guys, welcome to today's video. My name is Parris on behalf of Truth Body Systems, and here we have Steve, an amazing client with us here today. So, Steve and I have been working together for roughly 4 months. We started with a little bit of a body recomposition phase where we focused on eating in a slight calorie deficit, sufficient protein intake, and just really kicking ass in the gym. Then we turned things up a little bit and got more aggressive with our calorie deficit and went for getting lean. So, you know, Steve is somebody who has 2 kids, he has a family, he works as a paramedic, so he has a lot of shift work, and he's still been able to really stay on top of things. So I think it's a really good testament to not letting your lifestyle or your work life or your family life impact your ability to actually pursue your goals. I think a lot of people make excuses, and I think that, you know, Steve has done a really good job of never making excuses and always just sticking with it. You're not gonna have every day being perfect, but at least if you put your best effort forward, you know that you're gonna have the results on the other end. So Steve, if you had to say one thing that you learned throughout this process, what would you say?
I'd say probably the accountability has been big. The support network between Parris and the Truth Body System team, and my wife at home, who makes sure that if I don't go in the gym, she lets me hear about it. So that's been probably the biggest thing, is just making sure you got that group dynamic to help, the group atmosphere to help get you through it.
Awesome. Well, stay tuned. We're gonna hit a full upper body session here today, and enjoy. Okay, so I would say if you can do a working set with 65 probably. Okay, so let's start with the 40s. Hit the 40s for a few reps, then hit the 50s, then we'll go 60, and then you'll hit 65, okay?
Sounds good.
Alright guys, so in this workout we're going to do a full upper, so we're going to hit 2 different pushes, 2 different pulls, and then we're going to throw in some shoulders and arms at the end. So we're going to hit a flat dumbbell press, probably hit some pull-ups, and then some sort of row, and maybe another press, like maybe an incline barbell press, or you know what, we might actually hit some flies. Then we'll throw in some lateral raises, and some biceps and triceps after that. Haven't yet decided for that part what we'll do, but it should be fun, so stay tuned. We're gonna get a nice pump in this one.
Yeah.
So I usually find that a lot of people like to do lat pull downs, they do, or like neutral grip pull downs or other pull down machines. But weighted pull ups, if I had to choose one exercise that I think really took my back training and my back development to the next level, had to be weighted pull ups and weighted chin ups, right? And I think if you look at a lot of our clients' backs, the ones that can do pull ups, it really makes a big difference in terms of making things pop. I mean, nothing more badass than doing pull ups with weight strapped onto you, right? And if you're ever in a life or death scenario where you're on a cliff hanging and you have to pull yourself up, you'll be a lot more confident knowing that you've done these before. A lot of people really want big biceps, right? So they do a lot of biceps. But if you really think about it, the tricep takes up so much more space than your bicep does. So if you really want big arms to actually stretch the sleeve, A, you gotta hit more triceps, and B, don't neglect the long, heavier tricep, right? A lot of people do so much push downs, but don't forget that overhead work. Of course, we're not doing it in today's videos, but overhead dumbbells, right? Extensions, overhead rope extensions, skull crushers. There's lots of machines that hit that long head, so don't neglect it.
Let's go.
Kids and family and still being able to like crush it in the gym and crush it with their nutrition. So what's your secret to like, you know, managing the whole family scenario at the same time as pursuing this?
Well, I've said it earlier, but the having a supportive household helps. Okay. My wife and I both are able to manage that. And I find planning. If I don't plan the night before, if I don't actually set out and input all my stuff the night before, then it's very quick to fall apart. So if I set up my week, or if I set out at least a pretty good plan for the week, then that makes it much easier because I can't do things on the fly. Otherwise, I eat chips and ice cream.
Yeah, that's the key thing is planning. And I'm huge for it and I repeat it again and again in all my check-ins is like structure, planning, routine. And that's just because it's so much thinking involved if you're just going to go on the fly, as Steve was saying, right? So if you're someone who's busy, like pretty much everybody claims to be busy, well then plan ahead of time and put your nutrition at least on autopilot, right? And that way you're not having to think throughout your day and make decisions. No decision fatigue, you're just kind of running through, all right? That's a key tip from Steve here. So this is called an Egyptian ladder, right? So you have the cable through your leg, right? Come on.
Let's go.
Don't neglect your lats either. Everybody's focusing on, as I said, biceps and then chest. But if you want that V taper, the lats are so pivotal, right? And think about when you're benching, a lot of structure and support comes from your lats too. So if you want to bench a lot, you want to have strong lats as well. Yeah. See this? It's Christmas that came early. That's it. Just wrapped out a great workout. It was a tough one, but had a lot of fun. You know, sometimes it's okay to kind of veer from your structure with training and you know, like your programming and just kind of go in there, have a good time, especially if you're with one of your friends, or in this case, one of my friend and client, Steve. So best of both worlds. So yeah, great workout. Hit some chest, back, shoulders, arms. Just got a good pump, threw some weight around. How'd you find the workout, Steve?
It was good. Definitely, it's been a while since I've been able to work out with somebody else, so get me out of the basement gym once in a while.
Fair enough. And what do you think, you know, what's the goal now? I mean, we just finished kind of like a more of a fat loss focus phase, so like now, you know, going into building, what's the goal in your mind, or like what are you trying to achieve here?
I think just overall strength at this point. Like, it's been a while since I've had a structured plan other than what I can find on the internet, so to take this nice lead frame that we've worked hard and build it up into something that I can really push some weight around. So
yeah, definitely. And I think a lot of times people think of their goals as kind of like, okay, I'm gonna do this and then like it's done and like I'm happy or whatever. But I think for people to be, you know, stimulated and feel like they're ready to get out there and put in the work, you have to constantly set new goals. So instead of being like, okay, you know, I want to lose X amount of pounds, whatever, and then like I'll be happy, whatever. Instead you say, okay, I'm gonna lose this X amount of pounds, that's my first goal. Then once you're getting close to there, you gotta think, okay, what am I going for next? So in this case, it's like, okay, we knew as soon as we're finishing this like phase of getting lean, our next goal is starting building and get some strength in there. So like, how is our training gonna look in terms of that? And like, what is our diet gonna look? And that way you're never feeling stagnant and you're never getting bored. But also I just think it's like, again, really, in order to feel stimulated, you have to have a new goal. And like, if you're the type of person that's gonna follow through with your fitness goals, most likely you're the type of person that's gonna wanna keep setting new goals. And I think that's like a really important aspect of your fitness journey. Well, not only a fitness journey, but also life is like, you gotta set new goals all the time, or else, you know, things just get stagnant. Don't you agree?
Definitely. I've done that before too, after coming out of a structured program and then you just flounder, you got nothing really to build on. So it's nice to have, you know, phase two and phase three sitting there. You know they're coming somewhere, but
yeah.
What are they gonna do with them? That's different, but.
For sure, and like enjoying every phase too, right? Like, we talked about this a lot. It's like, we gotta enjoy the hard days when you're dieting and maybe you're a bit hungry or your workouts weren't as energetic, but then you also gotta enjoy, you know, the grind of like, when you're building as well. It's like, you know, eating more food, yes, but now we're really pushing in the weight room and there's tough parts of each phase, but there's also really enjoyable parts of each phase, right? And you have to learn to enjoy that and not always be, okay, the grass is greener on the other side, because it's really not. When you're in, you know, when you're trying to get lean, you're gonna be wanting to bulk. And when you're bulking, you're in your mind, oh, I wish I was leaner right now, right? So you gotta enjoy every single phase, and I think that's really the key to keep making things happen. Yeah.